Pongo boy, take it easy. What's all the hurry? Oh, Pongo boy, slow down.
At first, I was afraid we'd miss them. Perhaps they passed on by the park. Then suddenly, I spotted them. It was a perfect situation if I planned it right. Uh-huh. I couldn't depend on Roger. I knew what he'd do. He'd settle down on the grass and puff his pipe, and that'd be it. No, it was all up to me. Well... Now, at first, I had no particular plan. Just anything to attract attention. You know, stir things up a bit.
Pongo, you silly old thing! Come on! Come on, let's have it, boy. Pongo! Pongo!
For a while, it seemed to work. At least they'd seen one another. Things were going along first rate. But for some strange reason, they left.
Now, come on, you old renegade. We're going home.
But I wasn't giving up. I was determined that somehow they just had to meet.
Pardon, I'm so sorry. Please excuse me.
I must say, what on earth?
Oh dear.
Oh, really? Oh good heavens, of all the... Oh, my new spring suit and my new hat.
I'm terribly sorry. Please let me help you. I'm so sorry, Pongo. I don't know what's come over him. I'm terribly sorry. I'm so sorry. He's never acted this way before.
Never mind. Please, just go away. You've done enough. Please.
Oh, I say, here. Take mine.
Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto her, so long as ye both shall live?
I will.